It all began with Mary. The adventurous journey with Mary continues, and she still accompanies her daughters. As we journey towards the centenary year, let us have a glimpse of the personalities of our brave pioneers. One can almost experience a strong waft of Moravian air as the steamer carrying our first missionaries touched the Indian shores in November 1922. Before leaving Italy, they gathered around Mother Catherine Daguerreau, who placed a marble statue of the Blessed Mother in the hands of Sister Teresa Balestra, saying, "Have confidence in Mary. She will be a mother to you. She will guide and protect you." This lit up their whole missionary career. Sister Teresa Balestra, an Italian wise woman of 47, an experienced teacher with excellent managerial skills, with a genuine Salesian spirit and fired with zeal, was the leader of the missionary group. She was entrusted to preserve and safeguard the true charism of the Institute in India, and was earnest in building up a miniature institute in Tanjore, a replica of the one at Nizza, Italy. She often repeated, "Every duty that we perform with all our hearts leads us nearer to God. If God is near, why need we fear?" Her favorite slogan was "Sursum Corda," which means "lift up your hearts." She diligently planned her conferences and monthly recollection days. She led by her witness and inspired much fervor through her goodnight thoughts and the Salesian tradition of a word in the year. The community prayers were short but fervent, and supplied the fuel to keep their hearts fired with love and spurred them on the road to sanctity. In the year 1944, Sister Balestra was invited for the inauguration of the new wing at St. Mary's Wellow, which she had begun with only 60 children. In 15 years, she had the joy of seeing the center develop with more than 500 students. She spent a life of renunciation and hidden sacrifices from 1922, when she first landed in Tanjore. In 1952, Sister Teresa Balestra had a stroke of paralysis on her left side and was confined to bed. In the following year, she suffered another stroke of paralysis and lost her speech. The leader of the band of the first missionaries to India passed away peacefully at Brentwood Sacred Heart Novitiate, Kotagiri, on June 13, 1955, and was laid peacefully among the Kotagiri hills. All were profoundly grieved at this loss, for she had distinguished herself for her motherliness and the spread of the Salesian family spirit.